Anytime we, you know, as parents, as adults, we tend to tell a child, this is good behavior, this is bad behavior. A lot of times we actually tell them more about, this is bad behavior. We forget to tell them this is good behavior. And there are all of these conditions attached to, if you do this, then you're good. If you don't do this, then you're bad. The fact is, the child is a natural form of expression. The child does not come with any preconceived ideas of what is right, what is wrong, what he should do, what he shouldn't do, what is love like, what is not love like, what he must do to be accepted. But every time we label the child by saying, you know, if you do this, then you're a good boy or a good girl, and if you don't do this, you're a bad boy or a bad girl, ultimately we're putting the child in a box. Every label is almost like an identity. You know, and whether the identity is that of a good boy, or good girl, bad girl, or if it is about mama's whatever and papa's whatever, or if it is about, you know, bade hoke mera bachcha will do this, ultimately we're putting some sort of a label, some sort of projection onto the child, which ultimately puts the child in a box. What's the problem with that? The child is continuously going to be looking at the world through these filters, through these rules that the parents have given to him. I work with a lot of adults today. They could be the CEOs of companies, they could be homemakers, they could be successful in their business, or they could have, they could still be studying. They're adults today. Future leaders of today or already leaders of today. And all of them, when we really come to the core issue of what is the current challenge in their life, it comes down to something that they have learned in the childhood. Some label that has been given to them, some decision that they have made basis something that has been told to them. Something as small as, if you don't listen to me, I will do this to you. I'll give you my own example. When I was in class 4, one of my class teachers actually told me, ye toh moti buddhi hai. Now, as a child, I did not understand what moti buddhi meant. But I knew moti and buddhi separately. And I decided, just because I look a certain way, I'm stupid. And I went through life thinking I'm stupid. Till I grew up and one, understood what the word meant. Second, I understood that it was not about me. It was about what the teacher was feeling in that moment, and she did not know how to communicate. But I spent more than 10, 12 years of my life thinking myself stupid and actually preventing myself from coming out and sharing with the world the uniqueness that I was. And the fact is, your child is unique, as I was, as you are. You are the adults today. Can you love your child for the unique being that he or she is? That's all they want. As adults, that's all we want to know, that we matter, that we're good. But guess what? These things we learn as children, that we are good, that we matter, that we are lovable, irrespective of who we are. It's not about whether they listen to you or not. Give them a logical reason for why you're asking them not to do something. And it should not be, if you do this, then you know you will go to a bad school. The moment you're doing this, again, you're putting rules onto them. And they will run through their life just going through these rules that they don't understand. They don't understand why they should do it. Just like children don't come with manuals, parents don't come with manuals either. And just like we don't know how to raise children properly because we have not seen a manual and there isn't a to-do list, guess what? The child doesn't either. They're interacting with the world in that moment. And that is how they are learning. And every experience, everything that's said to them, and more importantly, what is not said to them verbally but non-verbally, is how the child learns how to deal with the world. And that is what you need to be aware of. How you speak to your child, what you say to your child, and what you define as good or bad, irrespective of a context, becomes a rule that your child lives by. Be aware of what you're saying to your child, because that defines the adult he's going to be or she is going to be.